Allergies Podcast. They got that funk.
Yo-ville! You are locked into episode 63 of the Allergies Podcast. The home of dope beats and pieces to make your backbone slide and other parts of your body tremble with delight.
On this month's funk-fueled episode, we've got our brand new song Vamonos to play you, which is big news around these parts, and the only way to kickstart your summer holidays. And that's a fact, people.
Plus, music from K.O.G and the other great acts we rocked out with at Green Man Festival this year.
And then there's also music from our very special guest, Ursula 1000, who drops by to chat it up and bless us with a 30-minute mixtape.
Oh, and let's not forget a tune of the month from the one and only Andy Cooper. It was a James Brown tribute 45 that'll get you on a good foot.
It's time to celebrate good music with family and friends. And when it comes to this show, dear listener, we consider you both.
Well, it is the Allergies Podcast, madam. Let's go.
I'm surrounded by half-wits, always on my back being brash and tactless. I guess I'm feeling fenced in from all the stress and tension. I should jump on a jet and go with no apprehension. Just watch me zoom away from this old gloomy haze. All I really want to do is have a little break and get away so I can find a couple UV rays. That we need a few plugs on the stage with two turntables and a mic stand. I've been waiting to roll. This whole thing really has taken its toll. Bogged down by the boss and all his details. Walking on eggshells, now I'm on seashells. Yesterday I was sat in traffic, mad, but today I'm laughing at it as I'm holding a drink with one hand open, squeezing a little bit of suntan lotion. I feel a weight unload because the pace is slow. So I lay in my robe, my phone on airplane mode. Sunbeams light up the skies, I'm so revitalized. I don't ever want to leave, identify me, better keep it under cover like private eyes. Dreaming and I really don't believe it, because a couple days ago I was going mental.
Look, I sold you percent. It's not about me trying to break your heart. Not about me trying to hurt it. It's about people that's left around me are the people that deserve it.
I better do work.
I kept my number the same for years. My now about to be ghost. I really hope you don't catch no feelings. Hey, watch out, watch out.
Be cool now.
Don't do nothing you regret. Don't do nothing, never get it. Do what the hell you want. I can care less. I don't give a shit. So much to do, feel like I got so much to prove. I don't need no drama, dummies and new friends. All I need is me and my crew. What you gon' do?
Be cool now.
The rest of your life, what you gonna do? It's night, all these hot chicks waiting in line. Got to act, learn how to act. We gon' drop a stack, gon' make it back. Gon' make it mad, we gon' make it last. She loves me, but she hates that. That payback is non-existent. Car service, you might miss it. I might send it, you like. I might skip it, I might risk it, I might. Just don't stand in my light. If we talk all night, just chalk it up to the height. We ain't no cornballs, we dance. Maybe don't make no other plans. Might just throw your ass in a pool. Might wanna bring another pair of pants.
Be cool now.
Yeah, baby. Just trying to get you to dance, girl.
Allergies Podcast.
Now that
is kinky. Oh.
Yes, 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 party people in the place to be. And I can only hope that place is actually the frozen food aisle of your local supermarket, because that's where old Roy Burt likes to hang out when he gets this blommin' hot.
Oh, cat's at the back door. Come on in, mate.
He's wearing a full black tuxedo. He's probably boiling too. I've got factor 30 on, and I'm sat in the house. Yes, you've been warned. I may burst into flames by the end of this next sentence. But if not, and we make it that far, let me break down some of the music I got to bless you with, Kat.
Hello.
At the start of the show. Show, out the way of the mic. Well, the big news around here is we have a brand new single out. It's called Vamonos, which is Spanish for let's go, as far as I know. But spell check it. And it features Mariette Smith, Andy Cooper, and us on production and bits and pieces. It's a summer anthem. You know, let me pull up the actual promo for that, and I'll read it. It saves me trying to figure out any more sun or holiday-based puns. Here we go. Slap on the sunscreen, the allergies are back with a vengeance, bringing in a 100-degree blast of blazing sonic sunshine for all the party people. The Promised Land Tour Guides have teamed up once again with soul sister Marita Smith and rap superstar Andy Cooper of Ugly Duckling for a new Latin-infused beats-heavy soundtrack that screams summer. Vamonos laces old-school boogaloo and salsa samples with sizzling hi-hats, claps and club-ready breaks. It's an anthem for beach bodies, holiday heroes and sunseekers hell-bent on escaping the rat race. Blah, 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 blah. It's an El Dorado where all the drinks are pink umbrellas and every bra is made of coconut halves. Yeah, pretty much captures it. So check that out on all your streaming platforms, or have it beam directly into your ear hole if you're somehow listening to this in the future where the technology has been developed. And also, what's it like over there? Is water a scarcity? Start stockpiling now, people, or learn to enjoy the taste of your own urine. Anywho, next up, and on the back of that was a tune called Phantom. That's a redux by a guy called Shirt. That dropped back in 2017, and I got hooked on it after hearing it on the soundtrack to Silicon Valley. If you know that show, brilliant, about tech geeks, and they're super nerdy and timid, and the soundtrack has always blasted jarring trap and like big rap tunes in that soundtrack to give a really weird juxtaposition. And I loved it. Great tune. I don't know much about the guy, but if you do, check me when I'm out, bend my ear, we can jack jaw about that and other things. And the third from the herd from me this month was a joint from our superstar guest DJ who's coming up later, Ursula 1000. That was the 20th anniversary redux of his album title track, Kinda Kinky. I'll be chatting it up with Mr. 1000 later to get the skinny on that, but head to his Bandcamp if you want a copy of it, and stick around there for the A Skills remix, which comes as part of that package as well. 20 years, 2 decades, and still sounds fresh. And speaking of monster singles worth shouting about, let me bid you goodbye. And take the time to say in a portentous voice, it's time for
Tune of the Month!
Hey, this is Andy Cooper. Thanks for making my track. It was James Brown, the Tune of the Month on the Allergies Podcast.
Well, I decided I wanted to make a track that was so illegal that no one would possibly believe how many laws were violated with regard to sampling. And I have done that now. I have sampled more valuable catalogs than anybody can legally keep track of. So that's what this song was about. And the good people at Spasibo were happy to abet my crime. So sometimes you need a co-conspirator, and they gave it to me as far as an opportunity to make this track. And I love James Brown. He's the foundation of hip-hop music, of course. And it's coming out on August 27th. Thank goodness. It took a while. So check this out. It was James Brown.
I gotta kick this thing off. Yeah. Can I kick it off? Yeah.
James Brown. James Brown. James Brown. James Brown. James Brown. James Brown. James Brown.
David Ruffin. Quick to rip a microphone without a big discussion. You thought it was an old brand new Nubian production? Well, it was James Brown. Salt pepper shaking that thing on the dance floor with some tight ripped jeans. They had a hit and here's the means. What? They used that James Brown. Ooh, it's the bomb. Can I get a soul clap? Come on! And if you don't know how they made this song, they had James Brown. Oh, 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 and I quote, let me clear my throat, but they didn't play one note. It was James Brown. I was about 15, had a flat top and a dance routine. 1990, Chuck Rock jumped up on the scene with some James Brown. I wanna rock right now, and Rob AC made me go wild. If you really wanna know how, he used some James Brown. Remember that it ain't where you're from, it's where you're at.
You got
if
it.
You don't know how to name this track,
you got it.
They use that James Brown. NWA, 100 miles and running LA. This beat by Dr. Dre? Nah, it was James Brown. Lords of the Underground? James Brown.
I'm coming.
Big Daddy Kane got raw with some James Brown. Gangsta, they use that James Brown.
Yes, the rhythm, the rebel.
James Brown. It's James Brown. It's James Brown. That's some James Brown. You know what I mean? The Godfather earned respect and laid the foundation. Don't forget how many moments of classic rap were built up on the back of a JB's track. So when I wanted to do my own song, there's only one way that you can't go wrong. The man who invented the hip-hop sound. I use some James Brown.
Like we rap.
The Allergies Podcast.
Thank you. sensory deprivation to ultimate synesthesia, freeing our brother's keeper from teeth of another creature, breaking and entering to the theater. The search and seizure is the birth of genius, somewhere between Earth and Venus. At her convenience, even non-believers make prayers. Haters and naysayers is buried in cake layers. I take day as a blessing and see the night as a lesson. Twilight is a message for me to write a confession. The matrix, a dominatrix seeking to be served, ever patiently waiting with the demons we deserve. Better be willing to pay for every dream that you deferred. If the vehicle should swerve, learn to lean into the curve. After working up the nerve, almost equal in size, I walked around with the iron for any wrinkle in time. I paid a piece of my mind for every nickel and dime, but never less than a five, and never slept on a job. A killing threat on your squad, yet never left the garage, where your guide was close enough to see the flesh of his eyes. Get to the button and press, it's what the message advised. What's the threat behind the message where the testament lies?
What up, party people? It's your boy Rackabeat here, back from the stinky fields of festival life. I think we're up to like number 13 or something ridiculous by now. But I tell you what, on Thursday night, we had an absolute highlight. We played Green Man Festival. I've always wanted to do the live show there, and this year we did it, and boy, did it go off, man. Big love to Chai Wallers for having us on their stage. And yeah, I had such a great time at the festival. I wanted to highlight some of the acts that played there at Green Man this year. So Michael Kiwanuka headlined on the Sunday night at Green Man. So I started off my three with a new track from Danger Mouse and Black Thought's new project. They've released an album called Cheat Codes, and that track featured Michael Kiwanuka. If you're a regular listener on the podcast, you would have heard me rant about how much I love Danger Mouse as a producer, and the roots Black Thought as well. That album is available right now. Go and check it out. It's called Cheat Codes, and it's well worth a listen. So the next track was from Aflasaki and Afrik Bawantu. So anyone listening to the show knows I love my Afrobeat, and there were some great Afrobeat acts playing at Green Man on the Chai Wallis stage this year. These guys ended up playing right before us and absolutely tore the roof off the place. Some incredibly talented musicians.
Much more talent than us.
Took to the stage and played all manner of wonderful instruments. That track was called Life on the Street. Go grab it online somewhere. And finally, one of my other favourite Afrobeat artists, it was K.O.G. He played Sunday night in Chai Wallis. I missed him yet again, gutted. But just wanted to highlight him on the show once again. Absolutely dig his music here and hope to collaborate with him one day. That track was called Mayadeen, and that is taken from his new album Zone 6. I played something else from that album on the show before called Ayana. Yeah, incredible. Incredible musician, go check it out. Thank you so much to everyone that came to Green Man and all the festivals actually this summer. We've had a right hoop, we've got a few more to go. We're playing Camper Calling up near Birmingham this Saturday. We are doing Camp Wildfire on Sunday, and then we're doing Lindisfarne up north. And then a DJ set at Mucky Weekender as well. And that is us done. I'll be ready to stick a fork in me and bunker down and work on some new music or something like that. Please, please go and check out our Patreon page if you're enjoying the podcast. It's the way to support the podcast. We ask all of you, literally all of you, if you could just chip in a couple of quid a month. It helps us keep this going. www.patreon.com/theallergies. Hoo-ha, hoo-hoo-ha. Right, now it's time for DJ Money Shot and a very special guest.
Yes, dear listener, it's guest mix time on the Allergies Podcast. And on the line and in the hot seat this month, we have none other than the Dapper Don DJ and producer, Ursula 1000. Greetings, sir, and welcome to the show.
Hey, how's it going? Thanks for having me.
Anytime. Well, I know and love you, but for those that might not know, can you kindly give us a one paragraph sum up highlights reel of your biography thus far?
Wow, let's see. Well, started this Ursula 1000 project actually in Miami when I was living there, and then I moved to New York in 98. Kicked off with a debut album in 2000 on Thievery Corporation's 18th Street Lounge music label, and was with them for about 5 albums, I believe, and started my own imprint called Insect Queen Music, and been releasing music under that since. And yeah, just been, you know, working, put out an 8th album, and did a little kind of singles of the month club release last year during the whole kind of pandemic lockdown thing, just gonna kind of get myself and the creative juices flowing and busy. And this year marks the 20th anniversary of my second album, Kinda Kinky, so excited about and also shocked that it's 20 years, which is insane, but embracing it nonetheless, and putting out a reissue remixed version of the title track. So that'll be coming out this summer.
And stop the clock. He's done it in record time. That's the full bullet points of your career thus far. We can just leave it there. That's all my questions and more answered. Yes, mate. So that it does mark 2 full decades since the title track of Kinda Kinky. And you mentioned it there, and we played it at the top end of the show. That's how we got things kicking off. I saw that pop up on Juno, so I was like, I've got to get you on the phone to talk about this one. So that's Kinda Kinky, title track off the second album. You've done a redux of that, so remix, in other words, and there's a special version on the flip as well, right?
Yeah, I wanted to get, since I'm putting this out on 7-inch, I wanted something that, you know, kind of like funk 7-inch breaks DJs, producers, etc. would get a kick out of, and I thought, who could be a good candidate? And I don't know, just I've always shockingly never had A Skills do a remix for me, so rang him up, and yeah, he ended up doing a really cool kind of kind of like funky, giggly disco kind of thing, you know, really cool, really, really cool flip on it. Yeah, so I really like what he did. For some reason, he originally did a dub, and which it has like giggling and stuff in it, and I think that's what he was intending for the flip side, that maybe it was something that he can kind of like scratch and kind of like go nuts on. But then I also requested like a vocal remix just for like your, you know, usual kind of like listener. So the dub and my remix are on the vinyl, and then those two plus his vocal remix is on, will be the digital thing. So, you know, the digital will have technically an exclusive. And I'm still kind of like toying around with it because it's kind of a ridiculous version. But I did like a full on like acid house version with like sirens and, you know, the whole bit.
For the whistle posse.
Yeah, because there's that part in the song where it's like, well, meanwhile, in another part of town. So I'm like, oh, this remix is that other part of town.
The warehouse district.
Exactly. So this whole remix is that. So it's pretty cool. You know, I did the car stereo sound test and everything. I still haven't played it out yet, but that might be some kind of like exclusive, or, you know, like some giveaway or something, you know, down the road. So
you're speaking there about the car stereo testing system. That's tried and tested for producers going way back. If it sounds good rattling the trunk of your car, then it's going to sound good elsewhere, right?
It's funny because, you know, living in New York, you know, we have a pretty good metro system here. So when my wife and I moved here from Miami in 98, we're like, we got rid of our cars, so we didn't have a car. And it's funny because like from 99 or whatever to like, I don't even know, about 2 years ago, we didn't have a car. And that was the one sound check that was driving me crazy, because I work on a track, I would listen to it on crappy speakers, listen to good speakers, listen to it in a club. I'm like, damn, that car stereo sound check, that's the one that's eluding me. And now, like, I finally have it, so.
It's right up our street. And the redux that you did, how did you put your fresh spin on that sound?
So for me, that was interesting. I actually shockingly did not have the stems for the song. I mean, like I said, we're going back to like 2002 here. And I'm like, I can't believe I don't have the stems for this. So after tracking them down with from the co-songwriter, Dr. Luke, who had them, he looked in. Thankfully, he's got all his stuff organized. I got them, and that was kind of cool to revisit, you know, 20-year-old stems. And you're like, wow. You know, I mean, they weren't half bad, but there were some things that were like, there's some doctoring that need to be done, and I just, you know, wanted to give it a whole brand new fresh beat. I kind of like retweaked some of the percussion, and added some new synth lines and stuff, you know, just to kind of give it a little oomph. So,
indeed, it must be strange opening up projects from that old, like reading an old diary or something. And
oh yeah, no, for sure. I mean, the whole revisiting this thing is so wacky, because even the girl who does the vocals, Rebecca Mader, at the time, you know, we're in New York, she's kind of like an up-and-coming actress, model, and, you know, and now, you know, she's been on Lost and all these like different shows and things, and so it's just, it was interesting to see everybody's career at the time, and then, you know, 20 years later.
And someone else you brought back into the fold as a collaborator on the visual terms, because the illustrator from the original artwork was back on board to do a redux himself for the cover, right?
Yeah, actually, the image that he did of me, this is what we're talking about, Shag, California-based, kind of the guy who really kind of kicked off the whole space-age bachelor pad-looking kind of artwork, you know, from kind of a 50s, 60s, that whole kind of vibe. which I was like lucky enough to get him on board back then. He had actually done a portrait of me behind some turntables, and it was always on the back of the cover of the vinyl of the album. And I just thought it was always kind of lost back there. And since, like, you know, now in this day and age, you just see like front cover thumbnails. So I thought, let me put that in the front cover now. So
pride of place. And you mentioned the 60s there, which is an area you like to dig back into. You kind of take the best parts of that swinging London groove, mix it up with exotica, lounge, turbo lounge, funk, disco, a pinch of kitsch. Before updating it with kind of like modern production polish, big beat. You've always kind of struck that happy medium between the retro and futuristic, haven't you?
Yeah, I mean, and you know, that era is just so near and dear to me, even though, I mean, I grew up in the 80s, and you know, when it comes to guilty pleasure stuff, and I usually always go to like new wave and post-punk and stuff, that's the stuff that kind of, is super nostalgic for me. But the 60s sound has always been more influential for me on my production side for some strange reason. And so, yeah, I never grow tired of just kind of funky music library kind of sounding stuff, and, you know, just Latin jazz from that era. And spy soundtracks and the whole bit, and then, you know, of course, everything that was going on at the time when I was starting, you know, in the mid to late 90s. So, you know, you have, you know, big beat going on in the UK, you know, just kind of like German club pop happening, Japan doing their kind of Shibuya Key kind of crazy sampling, throwing in, you know, bossa nova and frangieia and all this stuff, you know. So, and then, you know, plus having gone through the whole acid house and electro and all that kind of stuff too. I mean, all that stuff just kind of gets thrown in, and it's always been a fun science experiment for me to see, what sticks and what kind of weird mutation you can make out of all of this.
Well, it was part of a whole revival then. Do you think that kind of revival's back again, and it's flushing the cheeks of different producers now who are digging back into that old sound? It's a timeless sound, but you think we're on the cusp of that kind of 20-year cycle?
I think so. I mean, because, you know, it's always been party music, even though a lot of journalists have always kind of poo-pooed on, big beat and all this kind of stuff, being very throwaway. I mean, when it comes down to it, it's such a good mood. It always, for, at least for me, has always rocked a party. And that kind of vibe and sound, I don't know. I just, I don't think it ever really truly went away. And yeah, I've been hearing definitely that kind of element, you know, popping up, and definitely a lot of new producers.
Mm-hmm. And you mentioned acid house there with something near and dear to you, and you also mentioned your single of the month club, and those two things line up, don't they?
Yeah, for sure. I had definitely there's one track called Automatico on my single of the month club, one that was very much kind of leaning towards acid house, but not in a pastiche way. I mean, you know, the acid bass lines are there and everything, but still kind of like trying to doing a newer tweak on it. But there's just something about that kind of like squelchy rolling kind of, you know, thing going on in the background. I don't know, just it always brings a smile to my face.
And how many singles did you check off on the calendar of the Single of the Month Club? Because there was tracks with Emma Noble on there, friend of the show.
Yeah. We ended up doing five of them, yeah. Mm-hmm. So, yeah, it was five of them. And like I said, it was a weird kind of time where, no one was really traveling. We're all kind of like in lockdown. But, you know, I was thankful that I still was getting, you know, just kind of turned on by things and wanting to do something and not being just stifled and, being all glum. And I thought the Single of the Month Club thing was a fun way to, I don't know, explore different kind of sounds on things that aren't necessarily part of an album package per se. Of course, in retrospect, I listen back to those tracks and I think these could have easily all been on an album. So, you know.
Get them compiled. So they're available from your Bandcamp page, which is ursula1000.bandcamp.com. So send people that way if they want to pick those up, right?
Yep, so on that and pretty much everywhere, Spotify and YouTube and wherever you get your music. Juno has it, you know, TrackSource, Beatport, etc.
Excellent. Well, that gets us right bang up to the one real true reason we've got you on the show. It's to supply us with a fabulous and funky 30-minute guest mix. Before we press play on that, why don't you give us a little rundown of some of the treats and beats we might expect on that?
So yeah, I put together a 30-minute mix of just a lot of just lounge core breaks, you know, kind of like sample fest kind of stuff. Some exclusive remixes that I kind of did, little things that I do for my DJ sets, though. So nothing that's been officially ever released. Things like, what did I do? There's a Love Buzz remix I did of Shocking Blue. There's a Sarah Vaughan, Whatever Lola Wants remix. You know, just really cheeky stuff. And then brand new stuff from X-Ray Ted, for instance, a track called Doing My Thing, which, you know, like we were speaking about earlier, like this could have easily come out in, you know, 1999 or 2000, you know, so.
Yeah, because that 45's got a Return of the Original Art Form pastiche on there as well, so.
That's right.
Squarely in that era.
Yeah, and also and Voodoo Cuts, which also something new, doing that a track called El Chino, which is just like very, you know, Latin breaks kind of like, kind of a thing, which also could have come out back then too.
And an Ace Girls collabo, is that a Dave Allen theme remix? Bit of a classic.
Yeah, that was like, I forgot what that was from. I don't know whether a lot of the finger licking guys ended up doing a whole KPM remix series thing. I'm not really sure if these were like little one-offs, but I've always, I always thought that was like a fun kind of no-brainer.
Yeah.
A French producer, Bougalox, did a cool like Serge Gainsbourg flip on Chez Le Yaya. And our buddy Decline did a cool Boogie Beggin' remix of Beggin' from Frankie Valli and the Four Seasons. Yeah. So yeah, just fun stuff.
I mean, that's a massive track. I think Paluski did a version of that as well a while back.
Yeah, I want to say he was the first one, I think, that kind of did like more of like a proper edit, you know. Mm. I don't know if he added, maybe he added some kind of like a little.
I think it was for an advert, because I've got a promo 45 and there's kind of a cover that looks like a still from an advert. So maybe he got the call up and then it kind of gained a bit of traction.
Right, I could see that.
Yeah, man. Well, that's amazing. Can't wait to press play on that. It's the perfect time of the year for this kind of robo boogie. Can we catch you on Twitch as well? If people want to hang with you online, are you still on twitch.tv/Ursula1000?
Yeah, for sure. I definitely, when the single comes out, so that single comes out on vinyl, and this is exclusive through Juno. So you can get that through them. And then 2 weeks after that, I think it's September 12th, the actual kind of kinky remix comes out on streaming and download services pretty much everywhere. Yeah. August 29th, the vinyl comes out on Juno, exclusive on Juno, and then the September 12th is when it comes out everyone on all the other streaming and downloading platforms. And I'll probably be doing some shows and definitely some Twitch stuff in September.
So yeah, check in on Juno. There's pre-orders or at least buy links up there for when that drops. It's going to be in our charts. So check out our chart attacks on Juno. And hold tight, because right about now, we're opening up the airwaves for the Funkadelic widescreen, Turbo Lounge Master himself, the living legend, and this month's guest, Ursula 1000.
Yeah, thank you for having me.
You're listening to the supersonic stereophonic sounds of Ursula 1000. Crank it up a little bit. Supersonic stereophonic sounds. We'll be right back.
1,000.
Ursula, 1,000.
Zoubi 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 z I'm doing my
Ursula 1000.
Le beat fantastique.
Now for something completely different.
Put your loving hand out.
Thank you.
Ursula, Mirula, Mirula, Ursula, Sen,
Ursula,